All India Radio presents Morning News. Good morning, I'm Gunmala Kapoor. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says New Delhi's $1 billion line of credit for development of Far East region of Russia will be a take-off point for India's ACT Far East policy. ISRO scientists gearing up for historic moment when India's moon lander Vikram touches down on the lunar surface tomorrow morning. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu calls upon Indian diaspora to counter false propaganda against India after reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir. President Ramnath Kovind to present the Swachh Bharat Mission Awards in New Delhi today. And in tennis, Serena Williams enters the final of the US Open, beating Elena Svitolina of Ukraine. Prime Minister Narendra Modi returned to New Delhi this morning after completing his two-day visit to Russia. During his tour to Vladivostok, the Far East region of Russia, the Prime Minister attended the 5th Eastern Economic Forum, the EEF, the India-Russia Annual Summit, and also held bilateral meetings with several world leaders. Addressing the plenary session of the EEF, Mr. Modi announced a line of credit worth $1 billion for development of the Far East region of Russia, giving a new dimension to economic diplomacy. He said this announcement will prove to be a take-off point for India's ACT Far East policy.
यह पहला मौका है कि हम किसी देश के क्षेत्र विशेष को लाइन ऑफ क्रेडिट दे रहे हैं। मेरी सरकार की एक्ट ईस्ट पॉलिसी ने ईस्ट एशिया को एक्टिवली एंगेज किया है और ये मेरा पक्का विश्वास है। यह कदम हमारी इकोनॉमिक डिप्लोमेसी में भी एक नया आयाम जोड़ रहा है।
Mr. Modi said with the start of the proposed Vladivostok-Chennai sea route, the relations of both countries will be further strengthened. He expressed happiness at the signing of more than 50 business agreements at the EEF platform. The Prime Minister thanked Russian President Vladimir Putin for inviting him as a chief guest at the EEF and for his love for India. On the sidelines of the Eastern Economic Forum, Mr. Modi held bilateral talks with his Japanese and Malaysian counterparts and with the Mongolian president. During his meeting with Malaysian Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad, Mr. Modi raised the issue of extradition of Zakir Naik and asserted that Indian officials will continue to hold deliberations with Malaysia in this regard. Our correspondent has filed this report.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi's maiden visit to Vladivostok touched new horizons in the bilateral cooperation between India and Russia. The Prime Minister's announcement of $1 billion line of credit has given new dimension to the country's economic diplomacy. In the presence of Russian President, the Prime Minister unveiled the ACT Far East policy to boost India's engagement with Russia's Far East region. The exchange of 15 agreements during bilateral talks and signing of over 50 business-to-business agreements at EEF has demonstrated both countries' determination to boost trade and commerce and also expand bilateral cooperation to new areas. At the same time, the Prime Minister, during bilateral talks with world leaders, made it clear that India is ready to work in the multipolar world through multilateral organizations like BRICS and SCO and is always ready to put up joint effort to oppose global terrorism in any form. Suprashanti for AIR News, Delhi.
India's moon lander Vikram is all set to land on the moon during the wee hours tomorrow. Scientists at the Satellite Control Center of the ISRO Telemetry Tracking and Command Network in Bengaluru are busy with preparations for the historic moment. Currently, Lander Vikram is encircling the moon in a very low orbit. ISRO said the lander will be subjected to a powered descent towards the lunar terrain between 1 a.m. and 2 a.m., which will lead the probe to touch down on the floor between 1:30 a.m. and 2:30 a.m. After about 4 hours of landing, Vikram will allow the rover Pragyan to roll out from it and to do probing of the lunar soil. More from our correspondent.
The 15-minute powered descent of the lander is considered one of the most complex operations the ISRO has undertaken so far. The descent is to be made in the thin atmosphere of the moon, where the gravity is very less as compared to the Earth, and the dust settled on the lunar floor is highly charged due to the almost unhindered bombardment of ionizing radiation from the sun for long. However, the National Space Agency is exuding confidence about the mission, as sufficient groundwork have been made for its success. The exploration of the uncharted territory near the lunar south pole is said to reveal more secrets about it than what is made known so far. Jai Singh, AER News, Bengaluru.
ISRO Chairman K. Sivan has said that this will be the first soft landing for the space agency.
On 7th, from 35 km onwards, the powered descent will start. For 15 minutes, this descent will start. The 15 minutes is still, it is in our mind. The reason is we are not reached that point. When you talk about the 15 minutes, the 15 minutes we are talking on the lander. Whatever operations we have done till now, it's on orbiter.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi is scheduled to reach Bengaluru tonight and witness the landing on the moon. Earlier, Mr. Modi praised ISRO scientists for their achievements in this regard so far.
आप सभी को पता है कि 7 सितंबर को भारत का चंद्रयान चंद्रमा की सतह पर उतरने वाला है। भारत के स्पेस मिशंस की पूरी दुनिया आज चर्चा कर रही है। ISRO की, हमारे वैज्ञानिकों, हमारे इंजीनियर्स की क्षमताओं की पूरी दुनिया में प्रशंसा हो रही है। दुनिया हैरान है कि आखिर इतने सीमित बजट में सिर्फ और सिर्फ अपनी स्किल, एफिशिएंसी और डिसिप्लिन के दम पर ऐसे परिणाम हम कैसे हासिल कर पा रहे हैं।
दिस इज ऑल इंडिया रेडियो गिविंग यू द न्यूज। फॉर क्विक न्यूज अपडेट्स फॉलो अस ऑन ट्विटर @AIRNewsAlerts. Landline communication has been fully restored in the entire valley of Kashmir. An official spokesperson said that all landline phones have been fully restored in central, south and north Kashmir districts. Out of 111 police stations, restrictions under Section 144 have been lifted in 92 police station areas across the Kashmir valley. Officials said that the overall situation in Kashmir remains calm and under control. Eyewitnesses and officials said that people were moving freely with private transport plying the streets. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has called upon the Indian diaspora to effectively counter the false propaganda and negative narrative about India, particularly in the wake of the recent reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir. He was speaking in New Delhi yesterday after releasing a coffee table book entitled Glorious Diaspora, Pride of India, containing brief profiles of recipients of the Pravasi Bharatiya Samman Awards from 2003 to 2019. He said the overseas Indians must create awareness in the countries of their stay that dilution of Article 370 was purely an internal administrative measure and was aimed at accelerating the development of Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh. The Vice President said the Pravasi Bharatiyas must effectively counter such falsehoods and project the correct image of India. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh has called for collective international action to check perpetrators of terrorism and advocated strong measures against those who support and finance terrorism and provide sanctuary to terrorists. He said no country in the world is safe from terrorism and that India has been actively pursuing counter-terrorism cooperation bilaterally, regionally and globally through the United Nations and other fora. Mr. Singh was delivering a keynote address at the Seoul Defence Dialogue 2019 with the theme Building Peace Together, Challenges and Vision during his visit to South Korea yesterday. India and Indonesia have unequivocally condemned terrorism and the selective approaches in dealing with the global menace. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar held talks with his counterpart Retno Marsudi. Mr. Jaishankar has been on a 3-day visit to Indonesia from Wednesday. During the talks, the two countries also affirmed their shared interests in the territorial integrity and unity. The two leaders discussed the entire gamut of bilateral ties and held talks on a number of regional, global, economic, political and security issues. Acknowledging that the two countries are close maritime neighbours, Mr. Jaishankar, in a press statement, said that India values Indonesia as a key partner under our Act East and Indo-Pacific policies. President Ramnath Kovind will attend the Swachhata Mahotsav in New Delhi today. He will also present awards for outstanding contributions to the journey of the Swachh Bharat mission in various categories. Minister for Jal Shakti, Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, will preside over the function. Minister of State in the Jal Shakti Ministry, Ratan Lal Kataria, will be the guest of honour. In Uttar Pradesh, rainwater harvesting will be made compulsory in all medical and engineering colleges, educational and business institutions, along with government buildings. The government will also launch a massive public awareness campaign for conservation of water. More from our correspondent.
After a review meeting with different ministries and stakeholders, Jal Shakti Minister Dr. Mahendra Singh said that before giving recognition to any educational or commercial institute, the government will determine whether rainwater harvesting facility is present or not. It will be compulsory for all government offices at tehsil and block level to have rainwater harvesting system. Building plans will be approved only if there is a water recharge system. Sushil Chandra Tiwari, AIR News, Lucknow.
Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu will release the second volume of Lok Tantra Ke Swar and the Republican Ethic in New Delhi today. The books are a compilation of 95 speeches delivered by President Ramnath Kovind during his second year in office. The Sri Lankan Navy is sending two ships to Visakhapatnam to participate in SLYNEX 2019, a joint maritime naval exercise with the Indian Navy. The annual joint Indo-Lanka maritime fleet exercise, SLYNEX 2019, is scheduled to be held from tomorrow. Our correspondent has filed this report.
India and Sri Lanka enjoy a strong defense cooperation, and SLYNEX is the biggest naval exercise between the two countries. The week-long exercise will be attended by 323 Sri Lankan Navy personnel, including the commanding flag officer of the fleet. It will have wide-ranging naval exercises, including helicopter operations in sea. Sri Lankan Navy said the exercise signifies the desire of both countries to enhance cooperation and to further strengthen interoperability between the two navies. Santosh Kumar for AIR News from Colombo.
In tennis, Serena Williams reached the final of the U.S. Open, defeating Elena Svitolina of the Ukraine in a straight sets victory. In the semi-final played this morning, Serena beat Svitolina 6-3, 6-1. The second semi-final match is currently underway between 13th-ranked Belinda Bencic of Switzerland and 15th-ranked Canadian Bianca Andreescu. Both the men's single semi-finals are slated for early in the morning tomorrow. Second seed Rafael Nadal will play Italy's Matteo Berrettini in the first semi for a berth in the final. Nadal advanced to the semis with a 6-4, 7-5, 6-2 win over Argentine 20th seeded Diego Schwartzman yesterday. Nadal is the only former major champion left in the men's field following elimination of Federer and Djokovic, leaving him as a clear front-runner in his pursuit of a 19th major title. In the other semi-final, D. Medvedev will take on G. Dimitriov. And now for an overview of today's newspapers, it's over to Sarabjit Kaur.
Thank you, Gunmala. The Indian Express reports that a month and a half after it took off, Chandrayaan 2 will be ready for its final descent on the moon's surface sometime after 1:30 a.m. tomorrow. Chidambaram sent to Tihar jail till September 19 in INX media case is the top headline in The Hindu and several other newspapers. Modi raises extradition of controversial Islamic preacher Zakir Naik with Malaysian Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad, says the Asian Age. The Economic Times writes that Road Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari said that he would urge Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman to cut GST rates on automobiles temporarily to help revive the ailing industry. The Indian Express, in a tribute to Kiran Nagarkar, who passed away yesterday, writes, the bilingual bard of Mumbai gave Indian writing in English an electric charge, and soon you will be able to hire a guide to board Air India flights. Quoting an Air India official, Hindustan Times says, the services would cost between 2,500 and 5,000 rupees per passenger, depending on the facilities. And with that, it's back to you, Gunmala.
Thank you, Sarabjit. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says New Delhi's $1 billion line of credit for development of the Far East region of Russia will be a takeoff point for India's Act Far East policy. ISRO scientists gearing up for historic moment when India's moon lander Vikram touches down on the lunar surface tomorrow morning. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu calls upon Indian diaspora to counter false propaganda against India after reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir. President Ramnath Kovind to present Swachh Bharat Mission Awards in New Delhi today. And in tennis, Serena Williams enters the final of the US Open, beating Elena Svitolina of the Ukraine. And with that, we end the morning news.